Grandma from Germany was evil, and this is weird, because in Minnesota, she was, okay, I'm glad you're on board with that already, because usually Minnesotans go, oh, you know, we had a German grandma, and she made, like, you know, knoodle, and some spätzle, and had some stuff, and with the cool outfits, and the boo-boo-boo-boo, and she was great, I loved her. No, my grandmother probably had to leave, or there would have been charges. Are we clear? I don't know, I'm just saying she had the temperament. Anyway, so mean. She got to America at age 28, spent the rest of her life complaining about these immigrants not taking our jobs. Never saw the irony. She was something else. She was had a box wine in her bedroom. Remember, she's the classy side of the family. And I was visiting my parents one time. Have you guys ever lived with an old person that you secretly wish would die? You ever had that? Like, it's just someone that used to be cool, but about 3 years too far, and oh, Jesus, right? And that's a hard fact about life. One day you'll be that person for your family. Anyway, you climb the stairs at night, and you go, come on! And then you go, oh, hey, good night, Grandma. And she goes, well, that night, it was her birthday eve. She goes, Wendy, can you bring me a glass? And I had a party, and so there wasn't any glasses clean, and I yelled up, we're out of glasses, but I can bring you a funnel. I thought we were okay, because she seemed to chuckle as I did hand her a glass a few minutes later. But no. The next morning, I was awoken to my mom standing over me going, what did you do to Grandma? Like, what are you talking about? She's pissed. She's canceling her birthday. She said you called her an alcoholic. I'm like, not with that word. I mean, not many words. All right. So she goes, she better make it right. So what happens is she wakes up in the morning and she sees emails and she thinks it's her job to forward those emails out. I must forward the emails. That's how she does it. No, you don't. You could stop forwarding those crap-ass emails out to everyone and their sister. No, they come into my inbox. It says, please forward. Yeah, okay, forward the emails. So I had taken her emails about 3 months previous and written all her friends and family and said, could you give me pictures of her story? I'm going to make a book for her 80th birthday of all these memories people have of her. I thought that'd be so great. So I had already done that. So I showed up with a book and I said, I know that you're mad at me and I'm really sorry. And she goes, you can't just make fun of people. That's not right. And actually, you can. I'm doing it right now. What? And totally make money on it. Anyway, that was not the time. But suck it, Grandma. Anyway, so I said, I'm sorry, you're right. That is not a good thing to do. But I made you this book of memories of all of your friends and family, of things we love about you, and I'm really sorry. But here you go. And she opens it up. She's quiet for a second. She reads. She flips a page. She looks at the next page, and she goes, I don't even know that person. That's not a photo of me. This is a book of lies. And she threw it. I'm like, oh, Christ. And Mom's like, what do we do? And I'm like, let's take her to Disney, and we'll go to Epcot, that Germany section, because we can't take her back to Germany. Maybe she'll feel better if she goes back to the homeland. She's like, good idea. So we pack her up in the car, and we drive the 6 hours down to Orlando, and we unpack her in front of Epcot, and we wheel her up to Germany, and I go, Schau, Oma, das ist Deutschland. And she goes, that doesn't look at all like Germany. And I went, you know what? Barbed wire and cinder blocks didn't really fit in the happiest place on earth, Grandma. So they didn't have me back for a couple years. Mom was like, maybe you should just FaceTime, because it was intense last time you was here. It's true. You know, I think wherever she is, she probably thinks that's funny. So, and she's dead now, so we can all have a good laugh about it. It's okay. She's dead. And she died a good death, you guys. She died a death so spectacular. I wish it on all of you. Are you ready for this? She died during a routine colonoscopy. No, some of you seem upset. Some of you seem distraught because maybe you have one in your future. This never happens, by the way. It was a really, really freak accident where it turns out she had a little thin part on one wall of her heart, and when they stuck that thing up her butt, it changed the pressure and blew out like part of her heart, which nobody could repair because they were like in a dock in the box or something, so nobody was prepped for that. So she died, and that sounds terrible. You guys have gotten super quiet, but let's go over this again. A man who was attractive, by my mom's report, half her age, stuck his fingers up her asshole, and her heart exploded. That is not bad. And there were drugs involved. I forgot that part. She was high. Got some guy to stick something up her butt, and her heart exploded. People pay money to have that happen to them. And this was covered by insurance. It's not a bad way to go, you guys.